Thank you very much, Deputy Chairperson. Mr. President, Madam Speaker, and all South Africans, what an historic moment in our young democracy's evolution this is. What an honor it is to be part of this historic joint sitting, and what an honor it is for me to be part of the team in Parliament where we hope to restore the reputation of our Parliament to one that performs rigorous oversight over the work of the ministers and their departments. The role of the National Council of Provinces has previously been the target of pejorative nicknames, and this has been partly deserved, as the dominance of one party overwhelmed the rest, diluted the oversight role, and reduced our House to little more than a rubber stamp. That time is over. Section 42 of the Constitution directs the NCOP to ensure that the interests of provinces are furthered during the creation of legislation and in the subsequent monitoring and evaluation of the implementation of these laws. Importantly, though, Section 44 gives an additional role and charges the House with the performance of a senatorial role over legislation that does not directly impact provinces. What this means is that, noting the new composition of the NCOP, money bills and Section 75 legislation will no longer be able to be rushed through the NCOP with a predetermined outcome. Indeed, we saw substantial amendments to, amongst others, the Public Procurement Bill and the Bailer Bill as they were put through our committees in the NCOP in the 6th Parliament. That will continue. Senates and upper houses around the world are retained for their moderative influence over legislation in a less politically charged environment than the bigger assemblies. The NCOP is no different. The voters of South Africa delivered a clear message to political parties during the election. That message told us that no one party has all of the answers, and that we will need to put our heads together and seek solutions to take our diverse nation's needs into consideration as we find ways to rescue South Africa from the steep downward trajectory that has been driven by those who would break down what we have. We have been given a mandate by the electorate to cooperate and find the best in each other, compromising our solutions, but only when there is a better option that puts South Africa first. Where a whole new solution needs to be crafted, this must be done. That is the work of the President and the Executive. As we enter a new era of balance and compromise, it will be the role of both Houses of Parliament to ensure that the laws presented meet this mandate, and that the implementation of these laws and the wider focus of government departments as well all meet the standards that South Africans wish to see from this government. Mr. President, your speech last night was filled with hope. You reassured us that you know where the problems lie and you know what direction to take to set things right. So if I can repeat a line from my speech from the joint sitting when we debated the Economic Reconstruction and Recovery Plan, I said, bring the good legislation and we will help you pass it. Our position on this has not changed. We are here to build South Africa. The select committees of the National Council of Provinces will do our part to ensure that good legislation is passed and to ensure that bills are improved following consultation with provinces and with the public. And then we will monitor the departments on the implementation. Mr. President, congratulations on your election. Congratulations on filling a cabinet that reflects the response to the mandate that the voters have given us. We look forward to hosting you in the NCOP and your deputy and the ministers. You will be called there to account for all of your decisions. If you have done your job as demanded by South Africans, it will be a comfortable affair. But where there are failures, expect to be called out and asked to explain what solutions you are proposing. For many years, Mr. President, I've ended my speeches with a Sesotho call to action, because I am, after all, from Gauteng. That call to action has never been more apt. Ritswelopele, Kalfela, Kielaboha.